Hi, my name is Ed Rudiger, and I'm pastor here at Cove Presbyterian Church. I'm so glad you called our prayer line. Before we have a word of prayer together, though, I'd like to share with you some scripture and a devotion I wrote. The scripture passage comes from the 8th chapter of Luke. After this, the Lord appointed 70 others and sent them on ahead of him in pairs to every town and place where he himself intended to go. He said to them, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore ask the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest. Go on your way. See, I am sending you out like lambs in the midst of wolves. Carry no purse, no bag, no sandals, and greet no one on the road. Whatever house you enter, first say peace to this house. And if anyone there who shares the peace, your peace will rest on that place. But if not, it will return to you. Remain in the same house, eating and drinking whatever they provide, for the laborer deserves to be paid. Do not move from house to house. Whenever you enter a town and its people welcome you, eat what is set before you. Cure the sick who are there, and say to them, 'The kingdom of God has come near to you.' But whenever you enter a town and they do not welcome you, go out into its streets and say, 'Even the dust of your town, which clings to our feet, we wipe off in protest against you. Yet know this, the kingdom of God has come near. I tell you, on that day, it will be more tolerable for Sodom than that town.'" And here's a devotion that I entitled, "With Our Trust." As most of y'all know, we're starting a new World Series, this time between the Red Sox and the Dodgers. And this morning, as I was listening to some of the commentators break down the games, they started to talk about analytics. Now, if you don't know much about baseball, analytics involve using statistics to determine tendencies and probabilities, which can be used to play the game. And even though we've seen it used most often in baseball, it's becoming increasingly important in other sports as well. And you know, using these numbers, well, it just makes sense. I mean, why wouldn't managers or coaches use whatever they have at their disposal to put their teams in the best possible position to win? My gosh, doing anything else would just be stupid. And so they trust the numbers to help them win the game. And I'll tell you, Jesus challenged his disciples then, and he challenges us to do the same sort of thing now. But there's a difference. Instead of pointing to the numbers, Jesus tells us to trust God. You see, although other stuff may be nice, we already have all we really need to share the gospel. And if our work is successful, we can thank God. And if it's not, we can trust that it'll be successful somewhere else. You see, just like the Red Sox may enter the series with all kinds of statistics, we have something to carry as we go about doing God's work. We can enter our world with our trust squarely on the one who sent us. Let's have a word of prayer. Lord God, be with the caller. Give him comfort and support and hope. In the name of Christ. Amen. I'm so glad you called. I'd love to visit with you. If you're ever in the neighborhood, that's 3404 Main Street here in Weirton. Come up by Cove and we'll have a visit. Of course, if you're around here Sunday morning, 11 o'clock, we'd love to have you in worship. And so until I talk with you again, I want you to remember, you're a child of God, and God loves you very much. Goodbye.